Hello guys, today I'm going to talk about a new template that we have integrated inside the custom REST dialog that is going to make the connectivity to any Google services even easier than before. So most of the configuration is predefined and you just have to enter the specific information for the Google service that you would like to utilize. The Google service that I'm going to demonstrate is called Google Classroom, and apparently this is a pretty popular Google service that it's used by different educational organizations. So I have directly opened the page for the Google Classroom API, so it is going to be easier for you to keep track of what I'm doing inside our dialog. So I'm going to switch back to the Visual Studio project that I have opened here, and I'm going to start defining a new custom connection for the Google Classroom service. So I have opened the SSIS connection manager and I have selected the REST connection manager, and then I'm going to select the custom type and press the range button. We are going to start from scratch. The service is going to be called Google Classroom, and for the base URL, the documentation says that this is the service endpoint that we have to use. The base URL we have to enter here, and also in addition I'm going to enter V1 for simplification. So it is the service, and the suffix is going to be V1. And then we are going to select the authentication, and here is the new template that we have created, and it is called, in this particular case, we're going to use the Google user account. So the classroom has different authentication methods, but for the classroom it is based on the Google user account OAuth authentication code flow. And let's create a new authentication using the new template. We are going to select the Google user account, and here is what we have to do. Of course this is an optional step, but you may do it or you may not. So for the Google Classroom, most of the Google service have the so-called scope parameter. This is something that we can grab from the specific page for the Classroom authentication. So let's just get a couple of scopes that we are going to enter here as default value. They're space separated, I'm going to, of course, you know, if you need additional default scopes, you can enter them. Default scopes. And I would say that this is pretty much it. You know, this is everything that is required for you to now connect to the Google Classroom. So to confirm that everything is also working as expected, we should also define a test request. I have decided to use the user profiles get method. So I'm going to use this service request to verify that the test request is successful. And we're going to check for the requesting user. So it is going to be /ME. And let's now give it a try of the new authentication. Let's generate a token for the Google Classroom. And we are now going to press the next button for the authentication process to start. We have to enter a username. Here you can say progress. And Google Classroom Service is asking whether we would like to permit the COZYROC SSIS Plus to access the two scopes that we have defined. We press Allow. And here it goes. We have the token, access token has been generated. And there is just one more step to confirm that everything is fine. We are going to close this dialog and press test connection. And everything is good. So we're good to go. This is a very quick demonstration what it's possible. Thank you for watching our video. If you have other questions or concerns, please visit desk.cozyroc.com. For more videos and content from us, please subscribe to our channel. Have a great day.